Hello, my name is Matt Daniels. I'm a fashion design major here at SCAD. For my art history project presentation, my topic is Bodhisattva Padmapani. This piece of art took place during the Gupta period from 400 to 500 BCE in Cave 1 of Ajanta, India. But for today's agenda, we're going to look at the content, the formal properties and style of the work of art, cultural context, and the Western comparison that I chose for this piece of art. So if you look closely and you take a look here to the left, we have an in-close detail of the Bodhisattva. You can kind of see up close some of its formal properties. On the right-hand side, we have a look at the Buddha shrine inside the Ajanta Caves. We can see how the portrait hangs and how it looks in person, how the painting looks. So as I mentioned before, the Bodhisattva is located in the Ajanta Caves of the Cave 1 Monastery of the Buddha shrine. Here you can see outside view of what the caves look like. Again, here's a picture of the Buddha shrine that we looked at in a previous slide. The term Bodhisattva literally means a person that has been awakened by the Buddha spirit. Padmapani, it literally means one who holds the lotus flower, and the lotus is a huge part in the concept and creation of the Bodhisattva. So the Bodhisattva depicted here in this painting is Avalokiteshvara. He's more famously known for being painted during the Gupta period, which is also known as the Golden Age, which is characterized for emphasis placed on the expressionism and the naturalistic style of the Golden Age of that time. So now we're going to take a look at some of the formal properties of the Bodhisattva. Starting off, we can see that there's a perfectly painted external form. It's really smooth and rigid, and it uses earth tones to kind of have that naturalistic ambience of the piece. There's a triangular tiara that has perfect proportion of the oval face. You see downcast lotus-shaped eyes, full sensuous lower lip. So here it has a lot of character. You have the unibrow, which is neatly bow. And then we also have a chiseled nose. Moving into the next slide, some more formal properties include an expansive chest. If we were to blow the image up, the arms are extremely long because in Indian culture, the arms were representational of elephant tusk. And so that also goes into part with their fingers. They're long and tapering. There's a pearl string around the neck, which ties very much into the culture of the Bodhisattva. In terms of style, it's naturalistic. It's a calm, spiritual tone. There's a lot of expressionism, and there's very 3D thick stylized lines throughout the portrait. All right, so for our next slide, we're gonna take a look at the cultural context and how it influences in form and content. So in the right hand, you can see here that the Bodhisattva is holding a lotus flower, which in this culture represents spiritual awakening. It is said that this Bodhisattva, he denied his ascension into Buddhahood until he helped everyone else achieve Nirvana. All right, so for my Western comparison, I chose to do Leonardo da Vinci's Mona Lisa. It was created in 1503 to 05 CE. Here you can see a side-by-side comparison between the two. The Bodhisattva was actually created using a fresco secco style of painting, and Leonardo da Vinci's painting was used with oil painting. They both were staples of their time. This was a staple of the Golden Age. This is an important staple of the Renaissance. Here you can see they both have that naturalistic expression, more so the Mona Lisa than the Bodhisattva, but they both use earth tones and that naturalistic tone, and the mood and the vibe that I get from it is almost identical in a sense. So in conclusion, thank you for viewing my digital presentation on the Bodhisattva Padmapani. Once again, my name is Matt Daniels. I'm a SCAD fashion design major here at SCAD. I hope that you've learned something from this presentation that you can take with you and carry with you in your future. Thank you again.